How did you get cast as Bo Duke?
Well, I was I had done a bunch of theater in New York, but I had heard that they wanted folks from the South, from farms. They were looking to cast like extras, background stuff for this thing they were going to do called the Dukes of Hazzard, and they needed to be from a farm and between the ages of 24 and 30. So I was 18 from Westchester County, New York. So naturally, I told them I was 24 from Snailville, Georgia. Dude, there you go.
Yeah.
There you go. So that's what it was. There was no internet. They couldn't check and see if I was. They didn't. Eventually, they didn't care. But I couldn't have gotten my foot in the door. There was no way. They wouldn't have not have seen.
Well, you know, being so young though, how were you? Were you prepared for superstardom? I mean, you know, that's a big thing to happen when you're so young.
No. It's funny when it's when it's happening to you, you don't really realize because you're working. We Dukes of Hazzard, we filmed 12 days an episode. We filmed 5 days a week, 12 hours a day, and it was great. No, I'm not saying it was hard work by any means, but we were busy.
When you're 18, you don't get tired easy.
No.
Yeah.
But we were sequestered away on the dirt roads, and I mean, we weren't in the thick of anything, so yeah. I'd get done with work, and I'd go home and go to sleep and come back and go to work the next morning.
Yeah.
So I really didn't realize what was happening until years into it.
I was the same way. I mean, I made my first record. I'm still in high school. I'm 17. Yeah. I thought, well, if nothing to this.
Right.
I found out the hard way. But listen,
yeah.
You currently have a starring role in the Tyler Perry Show, The Haves and the Have-Nots.
Yeah, buddy. I'm having so much fun. Tyler Perry is truly the most amazing person I've ever worked with. I'm thankful every day that I have the opportunity to work with Tyler Perry. He's a force. And I'm going through some unpleasantries, and not a week goes by where Tyler doesn't text or call up and say, how you doing? How's your heart?
That's good.
And you know who he reminds me of in a very, very real way? Denver Pyle would do that to me. Uncle Jesse, the man that played Uncle Jesse, would always want to make sure that John's heart was okay.
Now, I have a recording studio and have had since 1970. I hear you have your own film studio in Louisiana.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Alicia and I have a movie studio. It's 58 acres, and we do two movies a year. But it's a wonderful place, but it is in a area that was underwater twice in 2016.
Is it close to Shreveport?
No, it's close to Baton Rouge.
Okay.
This guitar was damaged in the second flood.
I can see that.
And it's from 1936. When are you from?
Oh, wow. Well, that's older than me.
See there?
Yeah.
But it wound up with Alicia putting this guitar back in my hands and music coming out of me again, which led to the Ruffled Skirts album, which led to running into Paul Lime, which led to the 52 songs, which led to me sitting here with you, and I'm delighted to be back in
and
this
business.
And
we're delighted. Why don't you sing something for
okay,
us?
Okay, I will. I'm going to go
John
right
Schneider.
Sometimes I think about leaving, and if I had some place to go, I might even crank up the engine and roll down the street just for show. Nobody said it was easy, but that doesn't mean it ain't right. I don't want nobody else with me when it comes time to call it a night. And so far I've kept every promise, and this I'll continue to do. I love you like nobody's business. I wouldn't be me without you. don't need the rain to remind me how good it feels to come clean. The worst part of the past put behind me, the spoken words I didn't mean. If I have to tell you I'm sorry for something I shouldn't have done, it won't be for some other woman who smiles like she thinks I'm someone. And so far I've kept every promise, and this I'll continue to do. I love you come hell or high water. I wouldn't be me without you. I love you come hell or high water. I wouldn't be me without you. Wouldn't be me without you.